See, today we are going to discuss your very important subject, that is renovation and modernization of old thermal power plants. See, as you all know, in spite of adding lot of new capacity, we are facing lot of shortages in the country. That is because our demand is growing very fast. And renovation and modernization of old plants, it provides an opportunity. That is, if we can renovate old plants, then it can also act as new capacity. See, at present, we have around 22,000 to 25,000 megawatt capacity, which is in need of renovation and modernization. These plants, old plants, they are operating at lower availability and lower efficiency. So, unless new life is infused into these old plants, our situation, power situation will not improve. And if they continue to operate the way they are operating, then the installed capacity will not be operating fully. It will be operating at poor efficiency, resulting into unwanted pollution. So, and these are excellent sites, because initially best sites available were selected, and all your inputs are readily available. That is, coal is tied up, water is tied up, all clearances are available, rail linkage is available. So these sites cannot be abandoned also. And we have to make all out efforts to renovate these old plants by all means. Now, if we look at history in the past, we find that whatever plants were taken for renovation and modernization, somehow experience was not very good. In many cases, delays have taken place. In some cases, desired results were not achieved. And, well, if you take plant for renovation and it remains under shutdown for a long time, that nobody would like to accept such a situation. So it is very important that whatever plants we take for renovation and modernization, we should do very thorough planning for the renovation of the old plant. And for that, it is very essential that we utilize services of some good design consultant who would go into all the details of the problems which are being experienced in old plant. He will carry out necessary studies like RLA studies, your performance guarantee test, energy audit reports, interact with operators of the plant to find out what nature of problems are being experienced. And he has to think of various alternatives. That is, there cannot be one fixed solution for renovating an old plant. Depending on our budget requirement, we can have number of solutions to renovate the plant. So three or four alternatives must be studied, and then after discussions we can arrive at most optimum solution. It is very necessary that we make some provision for surprises, because in old plants See, whatever scope we may envisage initially, there can always be some problem areas which you discover when you open the plant. In many plants, it was found that when you open old equipment, some bolts are broken, some diaphragm is broken, and such things cannot be included in the scope of your renovation. So you have to make provision for such failures during opening of the plant. There can be some more surprises. So you must have enough budget in reserve so that if there are surprises, well, we don't keep plant under shutdown for those reasons, and we must be able to find solution for that and must have funds for that. Then we must tie up the finances beforehand so that, because for shortage of funds, we don't leave work in between. So planning is very important. Then, see, once you have decided the scope, you have selected a bidder, now time your timely execution of the renovation works, and to ensure quality of works is very important. So it is better we utilize the services of some implementation support consultant and quality assurance consultant. And throughout the execution of renovation works, these consultants must be playing their role independently so that at the end of the renovation, we see that our plant is executed timely and quality work is done. So, continuous monitoring during renovation and ensuring quality by independent consultants, I think that must be, procedure must be followed in all the plants which are taken for renovation and modernization. So, this is really very important topic, and I'm sure that with experience of all the experts who are available here, we will have some good recommendation by end of the day, and we would like to share outcome of this seminar with all those who are interested in doing renovation jobs, and I'm sure we are going to have very useful session today. So with these opening remarks, now I would invite other speakers to come and share their views with us. Thank you.